when he was six, his dad made him do drugs.
Mm-hmm. What do you want, Toby? Want to play with hot dog? Get here.
His parents divorced and moved to California. By the time he was using alcohol and drugs every night, he dropped out of school, decided to go to school in Ashton, focused on his work and took things really fine. It was hired for Saturday Night Live.
Toby, come.
SNL had terrible ratings and was fired. Still, he continued to work small roles in popular films like Weird Science, Less Than Zero, where he played a cynical brother who was kind of out of control.
Oops.
Then he went into rehab. Now clinic's over and he's ready to work. Oh, then he went to Charlie Chaplin. He learned the violin and became left-handed. Nothing will serve you better than a strong work ethic. Nothing. His performance got nominated for an Oscar. Drugs were never far behind. He gave in to his demons and hit rock bottom. Oh, again? Getting arrested and went to prison. His wife was fed up and left with his son. He took him into rehab again. Just because you hit rock bottom, you don't have to stay there. He took up meditation, yoga, and clean food, and finished treatment with renewed passion for life. His second act gave an ultimatum to stick to sobriety for winter. He's ready to give it all. His hard work paid off and he landed the role of Iron Man, which went on to make billions worldwide. He became one of the most influential people. And he helps children and visits them in the hospital. Oh, isn't that crazy? Wake me up if you see it. He also helped Robert's story. Robert's inspiring comeback is a story that you can always turn around. I better share this.